Good afternoon. I'm Captain Jay Thornton, the Training Division Commander. And to my left at the other end of the stage is Lieutenant Matt Dunn, the Training Academy Director. On behalf of the Chesterfield County Police Department, we would like to extend a special welcome to each of you for attending this important graduation ceremony for the 82nd Basic Police Academy. This is a group of recruits that not only made it through 32 weeks of basic police training, which started for them on July 12th, 2021, but they did so in the midst of ever-changing COVID-19 restrictions. At this time, I ask that you please stand as members of the Chesterfield County Police Honor Guard and the 82nd Basic enter the room, then remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance and the invocation.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Order, arm.
Will Chesterfield County Police Department Chaplain Lee McConnell please come forward to deliver the invocation?
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing us together for this extraordinary day in the lives of those graduating today, their families, our police department, and our county. We praise you. We thank you for the men and women of the 82nd Chesterfield County Police Academy who are graduating today. We praise you and thank you for their instructors, their mentors who have gone above and beyond to prepare them to be the best that they can be. We praise you and thank you for the Chesterfield County Police Department. We pray that you will bless our police force and keep them safe as they pursue their daily calling to bring about peace, justice, and righteousness in our county. Father, we pray that you will bless our graduation ceremony and be with those who will speak and impress upon the graduates your calling in their life. We thank you for the memories of this day that they will have for a lifetime. It's in the Lord Jesus Christ's name that I pray. Amen.
Please be seated. Thank you again for joining us today to celebrate the accomplishments of the members of the 82nd Basic Police Academy. I would like to take this opportunity to introduce the guests seated up on stage. Chairman of the Chesterfield County Board of Supervisors and Clover Hill District Supervisor, Mr. Chris Winslow. The Deputy County Administrator for Community Development, Mr. Jesse Smith. And the Chesterfield County Chief of Police, Jeffrey Katz. We would also like to welcome other dignitaries in the audience. Circuit Court Clerk for Chesterfield County, Ms. Wendy Hughes. The Bermuda District Supervisor, Mr. Jim Engel. The Midlothian Supervisor, Ms. Leslie Haley. Members of the Chesterfield County Sheriff's Office and Fire and EMS, as well as representatives from the Department of Criminal Justice Services, Mr. Harvey Powers and Mr. David Stone. At this time, I would like to ask Clover Hill District Supervisor, the Honorable Chris Winslow, to come forward and share his remarks.
Well, good afternoon. There we go. Welcome. And on behalf of the Chesterfield County Board of Supervisors and 365,000 proud citizens, it is my honor and privilege to speak on this special day that marks an outstanding achievement for our newest law enforcement professionals. Colonel Katz, thank you to you and your staff for the exceptional job in preparing our newest members of the Chesterfield County Police Department. The 82nd Basic Police Academy started on July 12, 2021 with 12 recruits. Seven successfully made it to this day. After 32 weeks, 1,216 total hours, 54 written exams, and 1,247 questions, getting here was not easy. Among this group, we have former teachers, a former police officer, a former police service aide. They're well-educated, earning their degrees or having had successful careers before making the noble choice to join the ranks of the police force. I am confident their wealth of life experience and wisdom will serve them well in their new roles. I am impressed and deeply moved by their determination and commitment to service. We have Officer Shepherd, who just so happens to be from my district and a Clover Hill High School graduate. He was injured in the 79th Basic Academy and then returned. I think that demonstrates the tenacity of this class and the very fact that this is not just a job, it is a calling. Our graduates today join us from near and far. Thank you to the families and the other loved ones who have made the drive here today in support of these graduates. We realize it's not just the police officer who makes sacrifices. Please know that you too are joining our family today. Despite all the training they have had, nothing prepares them to do this job more than the love and the support and patience that they get at home. As an elected official, I interact with many citizens. We like to have as many positive experiences as possible, right? But my interactions pale in comparison to that which even one police officer has with the public we all serve. There is simply no other job in government, at any level of government, that has as much visibility and direct public interaction as the one each of you are about to perform. Public safety, in its many and varied forms, is the most important service we provide in Chesterfield. However, police officers aren't just a front line against crime. Perhaps the most important part of your new job will be that of being a guide, a Gandalf, if you will. Perhaps the most important part, every day you will have opportunities to show compassion and professionalism towards others, steering them toward better decisions and better lives. The encouragement and security extended to those needing it most is immense and immeasurable. That makes your role crucial to our community's success. In short, your actions with citizens will be routine, but it may be the only interaction they ever have with a police department. So that doesn't create any pressure on each of you. I know you know that. Graduates, today, you officially join an esteemed family. Please know you have our board's full support and faith, that you have our trust as you take on what is a tremendous and critical responsibility in our community. To each of you, on behalf of the Board of Supervisors and this entire community, I extend my sincerest congratulations. And I wish each of you a long, happy, successful, and safe career. Thank you again for choosing Chesterfield County. You've picked the best, and God bless you.
Thank you, Mr. Winslow. Mr. Smith, if you would come forward with your comments.
Good afternoon, and happy Friday to everybody. Mr. Chairman, members of the board, Colonel Katz, recruits, families, and guests, thank you for inviting me to be here today for the 82nd Basic Police Academy graduation. It truthfully is an honor to be here speaking before you. I want to first convey congratulations to all of you on behalf of everyone in county administration, including Dr. Casey. He had a prior engagement today, but sends along his best wishes and thanks you for all that you do for Chesterfield. Public safety is one of the most essential services. Public safety is the most essential service that we can provide to the citizens of Chesterfield. Without the bravery and dedication of many here today, that would simply be impossible. Throughout the past couple of years, the pandemic has shown us even more clearly how much our public servants do for all of us, and they deserve our gratitude. So I want to take a moment to recognize those who wear the uniform in the line of duty, both here at Chesterfield and beyond. Thank you for all that you do and for the safety you provide to us every day. Next, I want to say congratulations to the 7 recruits who are graduating today. I'm sure many of you here know how truly long a process this has been since July, when these recruits began this journey. Back when the number of recruits in the class was nearly twice what remains. Each of you persevered and continued to work hard and have therefore earned this opportunity. On behalf of the citizens of Chesterfield County, I'm very glad to welcome you to the Chesterfield Police Department, and I want to extend our thanks for your service as part of our police department. Also want to say thank you to Colonel Katz and the many members of his department who have helped prepare these recruits to get them to this point. Thank you for all that you do. From the time you first started on this path, they've been by your side and helped you learn and grow, preparing you for what's beyond this police academy. Continue to lean on them in the coming weeks and months as you begin the next phase of your career. And having had the pleasure of working with a lot of these folks for the past 2 decades, I can tell you there is no better police department in the state, if not the nation. This group of recruits comes from a variety of backgrounds. Some may call Indiana or New Jersey home, while others come from farther away. But what unites you is the work you've put in these last 32 weeks, totaling what I understand to be more than 1,200 hours of structured learning. Lastly, to the families of those graduating today, as well as those in public safety overall, I also want to extend a thank you on behalf of Chesterfield County and all of those who will be made safer thanks to the selflessness and devotion of your loved one. We appreciate all you did and will continue to do to support these new graduates as they start their new journey. Again, thank you for letting me come here to say a few words, and thank you for all you do to keep this community safe.
Thank you, Mr. Smith. Colonel Katz?
You know, one of the challenges of coming up and speaking third and last is that a lot of what I prepared to say has already been said, but there's some value in reiteration, and we're going to talk a little bit about that in just a moment. So good afternoon to our family, our friends, colleagues, and graduates. I'd like to extend a heartfelt welcome to our 82nd Basic Recruit Class, a remarkable group of freshly minted Chesterfield County officers who identify with the moniker of the dogs. In this context, cats and dogs can peacefully coexist. In fact, I must admit that I am particularly fond of this class. Now, every class has its own unique flavor and personality, and this class is truly a special one, both collectively and individually. You know, like the movie Police Academy, if you remember that, this class contains an array of memorable characters. There's the quiet talker, the tactical operator, a serial entrepreneur who, as recently as last night, I learned is also an accomplished academic, an author, and a reality TV dancer of sorts. Seriously, he's got moves. This class contains a prolific reflective listener who apparently tends to perplex instructional staff with calm and deliberate questions to seek clarification. There's a recruit who perpetually and bravely takes the blame for any collective failure, and a graduate, and I love this one, a graduate who wants to turn everything into a taco. How could you not love such a colorful cast of characters? These new officers come from varied backgrounds and experiences, and this has enriched the learning process over the last 32 weeks. Now, upon speaking with this group last week, we chatted about how this original class of 13 lost one recruit a day for the first 4 days of this session. Suffice it to say, on day five, this group mustered up in the morning and side-eyed one another, trying to determine who might be the next to fall out. Fortunately, this trend broke on that day, and only one other recruit was lost during the class. The inevitable and predictable process of separating the wheat from the chaff was successful, and I am thrilled with the results. To our training staff, thank you for a job well done. To those of you from our personnel division, finance, system support, each of you have taken the time to make it possible for us to select, train, and equip our newest members for success. Thank you. And while I am dishing out copious helpings of gratitude, please allow me to extend a hearty thank you to the families of the graduates here today. Parents, grandparents, partners, spouses, and siblings, all of you. As I mentioned last night, you're all now members of the Chesterfield County Police family. In a sense, each of you will sacrifice to varied extents because your loved one has chosen the noble calling to serve our beloved community. And I want you to know that I recognize this, and our county administration recognizes this, and so do our elected officials. The support that you and your loved ones will receive as a member of our staff is truly second to none. And thank you in advance for the new and innovative ways you will celebrate some holidays and special events. Thank you for your patience and your love and your understanding of your loved ones as they see the very best and the very worst that humanity has to offer, and strive to maintain a balance of normalcy in the presence of such stimuli. We are highly selective of our staff. You should know that we select about 97 to 98% of those, I'm sorry, we reject 97 to 98% of those who seek employment with us. And it's noted again that only 58% of this class graduated. Those of you who are left are special. In fact, you have all the makings, each of you, to be elite public safety professionals. I trust you, and I want you to know that. I trust you to make those decisions that require your best judgment, even when it's not covered in policy. I trust you to go above and beyond in helping those who require our assistance to feel as though their circumstances are the most important thing to you in that moment. I trust you to do what's right, even when it may not be popular, to stand by your principles, to maintain a path of continual growth and self-improvement, and I trust you to wear the sacred badge of this office to represent this department and this profession in the manner it deserves. I do not, however, trust you with the process of caring for the flags in front of the academy. Fortunately for all of us, this task has now been passed on to the next basic class, and that's okay. Everybody's got something, and that's not a terrible place to land. At any rate, I want to take a moment to answer a few questions you may have as you continue your transition from learning the technical aspects of this career to socializing into our broader organizational culture. Last year, our agency's executive staff, which is comprised of our majors, our lieutenant colonels, and I, worked extensively to begin a process of providing clarity in our purpose, direction, and philosophy as an organization. So this year, we're working to ensure that we communicate this information. In fact, we're looking to over-communicate it. We recognize that sometimes we might come across as repetitive, but sometimes repetition is good and even necessary. I'm reminded of an example of a story I read about a wife who said to her husband, "Why don't you tell me you love me anymore?" And the husband replied, "I told you the day we were married, I'll let you know if it changes." So we took the time to answer five basic questions that each of you deserve to know about in terms of the direction and emphasis of our organizational culture. Now, why do we exist? Quite simply, our four P's: preserve human life, protect the vulnerable, establish problem-solving partnerships, and people, attract, develop, and retain top-tier talent. That's you. We're all recruiters, so congratulations, it's your first specialty assignment. How do we behave? Hungry, humble, and smart. What does that mean? Well, hungry means we work when we're not asked. We see something needs to get done, and we get to it. Humble, we don't think less of ourselves, we rather think of ourselves less, and that's an important distinction. And smart, not brain power per se, although that's important, but rather we value emotional intelligence, the ability to read a room, to connect, to develop meaningful bonds. This is essential in the important work that we do. What do we do? Protect, lead, and serve. It's pretty self-explanatory. How will we succeed? Together. Much of the work that we do alone, but as I said last night, we are a team and we'll lean on one another. What's the most important thing right now? SMART goals plus. What does that mean? Well, SMART goals represent our annual measurable goals, and the plus component refers to those things that are unexpected but essential as they surface. In other words, we are both strategic and adaptive. Who must do what? We must be dependable and depend on one another. As of this graduation, I want to reinforce, you can depend on me to serve as your chief. And I trust you to serve our beloved community as our next generation of Chesterfield County police officers. You will hear the answers to these questions repeatedly in the coming years. And when you do, think of the story I shared about the husband and the wife, and just know that you're loved. May God bless each of you and your families. Congratulations and thank you.
Thank you, Colonel Katz. At this time, we would like to take a few moments to play a short video that chronicles the experiences of these recruits over their very busy 32-week basic academy.
location?
Central.
What is your social?
216.
Cool.
216.
32699.
26.
11-14, Rezzy Register.
23rd, 1997. Ah!
Patrick Hogan, please come forward to speak on behalf of the 82nd Basic Academy.
Colonel Katz, Mr. Winslow, Mr. Smith, command staff, training staff, family, friends, graduates, welcome. Growing up, I was never a fan of graduations. Because of my own insecurities, I didn't want to walk at my high school graduation, and I didn't walk at any of my college graduations. Years later, I was telling a co-worker this, and she called me selfish. Confused, I asked her what she meant. She told me the graduations aren't for the graduates. They're for the people in their lives who sacrificed and helped get them through it. So before I begin, I want to thank each and every person who supported us and helped us get to this moment, because we wouldn't be here without you. So we can give you a round of applause. I'm not the most emotional guy in the world. I can count on one hand the amount of times I've cried in my adult life, and the last time I cried was July 12th, 2021. After a grueling day of physical and mental endurance, I entered my home stoically and calmly told my wife, "I'm fine, but I just can't talk right now." I proceeded to go to my bedroom, laid down on the floor, barricaded myself against the door, and began to cry. At the time, I was a 33-year-old grown man, laying on my floor in my room by myself, crying, thinking, 32 weeks. 32 weeks. Each day started off with us getting to the academy around 7 a.m. to aggressively lint roll each other and make sure that we were squared away before morning flags at 8 a.m. For the first several weeks, no matter how much we lint rolled, shined our boots, or tried to be squared away, there was always a piece of lint or hair, and we paid for it with character development. For the next several weeks, sometimes it felt like we couldn't do anything right and spent a large portion of the day developing our character. As time went on, we had a choice: to bicker and get angry with each other, or to come together and continue to strive to get better each day. We chose to support each other and pick up one another when one of us was having an off day. We started with 12 recruits. By the middle of the following week, we were down to 8, and a few short weeks later, we were down to our final 7. Having only 7 recruits meant that you couldn't hide, you couldn't coast, and you couldn't have an off day. The 82nd bickered, fought, came together, and loved like a family. What was nice about having 7 recruits is that I can say a little something about each of you. Carter, you're literally one of the kindest and most generous people I've ever met. I'm so excited to see the impact that you have in Chesterfield and the relationships you build in the community. Besides the cold weather, I don't think I heard you complain once, and you always had a smile on your face. Just make sure to stay away from pepper spray. For those of you that don't know, pepper spray and Carter's eyes do not get along. Clark, if you looked up the word police officer in the dictionary, you'd see a picture of Clark. Even though we broke your chops, it was great to see someone so excited and so driven and tactical. I was inspired by your work ethic and dedication, and whether you noticed it or not, I leaned on you for motivation on days when I felt like I didn't have it. Cook, it took a while to get to know you because you didn't speak to any of us for the first 4 weeks. Although I'm technically the oldest in the class, I'm sure our class would agree that you are the old man of the group. I found myself, even in my personal life, mimicking your patented, "Jeez." You're a wise young man, and although you're quiet, when you did speak up, we all listened because we knew it was going to be something meaningful. We're fortunate to have you, and I'm excited to see the impact that you have on the community. Grimwood, I'm the youngest of 3 siblings, so I never had a little brother. I think I got a glimpse into what it was like to have a little brother, where you absolutely love that person, but they also drive you crazy. You're one of the funniest people I've ever met, and I appreciate you bringing levity to our class at appropriate times and maybe at some inappropriate times. You're gonna do amazing things on the road, and I can't wait to see. Moffitt, sweet baby Moffitt. After finding out that I'm closer in age to your parents than I am to you, I almost threw up. It was special to see, to be able to see how much you've grown in the past 8 months. You started the academy timid and shy, and by the end, you held your own on the trash-talking front. Respectfully, of course. Please remember me and all of us when you make captain or major, and you're all our bosses one day. Shepherd, for those of you who don't know, it's Shep's world, and we're just living in it. Although today is a special day for all of us, Shepherd was recycled from the 79th Academy after getting hurt in week 16. She's waited and persevered a very long time for this moment. Shepherd is strong and capable, and it was amazing to see you begin to believe that throughout this academy. To Training Officer Redder and the rest of the training staff, we cannot thank you enough. Even though it may not seem like it at the time, we appreciate you all pushing us to be our best selves. Good wasn't good enough, better wasn't better enough. You challenged us every day to be the very best versions of ourselves. You kept us on our toes and set the foundation for our law enforcement careers, and we're eternally grateful and will make you proud. In closing to the 82nd, I know in the coming months and years, we'll be on different shifts and may drift apart in life, but I all want you to know that the bond that we've all forged here will last forever. Anytime, any place, call and I'll be there, and I know that you'll do the same for me. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, Recruit Hogan. At the completion of each academy, we recognize the recruits who have achieved the highest average scores in several categories, including firearms, academics, physical fitness, and overall achievement. At this time, I would ask Colonel Cass to please come forward to help present these awards. The Firearms Achievement Award is presented to the recruit who achieved the highest overall score in all firearms courses shot. In this category, one recruit earned an overall average of 93.25. Recruit Cook, please come forward to receive the Firearms Achievement Award.
Ladies and gentlemen, one recruit is the recipient of three separate awards: the academic achievement, the physical fitness, and the overall achievement. This recruit achieved scores of 99.04% in academics, 94.28% in physical fitness, and he achieved a 97.41% in overall score. Recruit Clark, please come forward to receive these awards. The Academic Achievement Award is presented to the recruit who achieved the highest overall grade point average in all written tests. Of the 55 tests that were taken, Recruit Clark earned a grade point average of 99.04%. In fact, he achieved 1,233 points out of the possible 1,245. The Overall Achievement Award is also presented to Recruit Clark for achieving the highest overall combined scores in academics, firearms, and physical fitness. Congratulations, Recruit Clark. Part of an updated tradition, the recipient of an next award will receive a financial gift from the training staff. At this time, I would ask Training Officer Redda to come forward for the presentation of the Inspirational Peer Award. The Inspirational Peer Award is determined by the members of the class. Members of the 82nd Basic voted for the person who they feel best demonstrated the characteristics of teamwork, selflessness, sincerity, and supportiveness. The class members voted and they have chosen Recruit Hogan. Please come forward to receive your Inspirational Peer Award.
Each officer will now receive their certificate of graduation from Colonel Katz. Sean Carter.
Hi, my name is Sean Carter. I'm 24 years old. I'm from Teaneck, New Jersey. And before this, I graduated from Temple University with a criminal justice degree. My dad inspires me the most. Seeing how hard he works, seeing how he came from not having so much to being able to provide for me and my brothers and have a really supportive family, and he's being like a really good support system. I feel like he inspires me the most to continue to work hard and be the person who I am today. I think I want to follow into Mr. Darrell Skinner's footsteps. I think I want to go into investigations and also negotiations. My favorite training staff memory is during practical week when Training Officer Terry and Training Officer Rutter, they pulled me to the side and they spoke to me, they gave me words of encouragement because they saw how bad I was beating myself up because I tried to be a perfectionist during practical week. And they were telling me that I'm going to fail scenarios, but I am going to pass. They're not going to let me lose my job. And they lived up to those words, and here I am. I want to start off by saying thank you to my girlfriend. She's been a really great support since the beginning of the academy. She knew how stressful it was for me, and she knew how much it just really changed me, and it changed me for the better. I also want to thank my parents, my mom and dad. They've been really supportive of me. I call them every day after work, and they're just there to listen to me and give me words of encouragement, like always. I want to thank Mr. Darrell for also giving me words of encouragement, helping me get through these rough 32 weeks, and my brothers.
William Clark.
Hi, I'm Billy Clark. I'm 22 years old. I'm from Fayetteville, North Carolina. And before this, I graduated from Randolph-Macon College. My favorite academy memory came in one of the first couple days. We had our first uniform inspection where Training Officer Redder took a string off of someone's uniform and let it float in the wind onto my uniform, where I then got sworn by the training staff and yelled at for the string that was on one of my buddy's uniforms. So that was my favorite memory. Chesterfield County, honestly, my favorite thing about it is the people. Everyone I've met here has been great, you know, getting to work with people in FET. Everybody really respected the police department and all the officers here. Every employee I come around, you know, they're really awesome, really approachable people. Honestly, it's the relationships that I'm looking forward to most, the relationships with other police officers. You know, Training Officer Terry says all the time, it's a brotherhood, and once you get sworn in, you get inducted into that brotherhood. So I'm really looking forward to those relationships with all the fellow police officers when we get out there on the road. I want to thank my fiance, being there every day, supporting me through the good times and the bad times. You know, she was always there, you know, stable. I wanted to thank my parents, my siblings. You know, I would call them whenever I, you know, needed a little pick-me-up, and they were always there for me. I want to thank my classmates. You know, they were there with me every single day, every break, you know, every session outside in the hot, you know, in the heat in July all the way to the cold of February. You know, they were always there for me. I want to thank the training staff for putting so much time and effort into us and, you know, doing everything they could to prepare us to become police officers.
Cody Cook.
Hi, my name is Cody Cook. I'm originally from Etna Green, Indiana. I'm 30 years old. Before I came here, I was a school teacher in Pennsylvania for a couple years. I think one of my top favorite memories is running around the parking lot, coming back and seeing my man Hogan laying on his back like a dead cockroach, pedal on his feet, kicking his hands. It's pretty great. I think the best thing about Chesterfield County is that the people that work here try to live up to the standards and expectations. So that I've worked for other places that have like a mission statement or like values, but then they don't really try to follow those values. So I think Chesterfield County does a good job of actually trying to reach the goals that they set. Really, I know it's kind of generic, but I'm looking forward to helping people. So I realize that a lot of things that we do aren't necessarily seen as helping people, but protecting people, putting away the bad guys, and just being a general aid to people in society. I'd like to thank my wife, first of all, as she supported me throughout this process, for sure. You know, I know it's not that easy to take care of the little guy, so she's done a great job with that. I'd like to thank my family for being supportive of me throughout my whole life, but especially through the academy. And I thank the training staff, and not just the training officers, but Sergeant Godwin, Captain Thornton, Lieutenant Dunn, everyone that stepped in various times throughout just to help us mold us into the police officers that we're becoming.
Jordan Grimwood.
Good afternoon, Jordan Grimwood, 24, from England. Before this, I worked in the automotive field. Favorite academy memory, all of the class one by one got called into the office and we got questioned about a code section and what it was in particular. And it took until our last classmate to get it, and we all still got it wrong. And so all seven of us were lined up in the office hallway, and Moffitt thought the good punishment would be for us to run just about 5 miles around the building, which was absolutely insane at the time. Just really want to get out there and kind of see what, once out on patrol, see what my favorite items to do are. But definitely SWAT is something I'm interested in the future. Definitely the person who inspires me the most is my dad. I've learned a lot from him, how to do certain things, how to deal with stress, how to prioritize a lot of things in your life, and I'd say my dad. I'd like to thank my family and all my friends. My family, I'd like to thank my mom and my dad, David and Lori, for really helping me through all of this and pushing me and making sure that I was doing everything I needed to. I'd like to thank all my friends for being patient with me through this whole academy process, understanding that sometimes on the weekends I was just, you know, tired and stuff like that, but really making sure that I had stuff to do outside of the academy, and that's who I'd like to thank.
Patrick Hogan.
Hi, I'm Pat Hogan, originally from New Jersey, and before this I attempted to sell real estate in New York City during COVID. Being class leader of the 82nd was a tremendous honor. It was very stressful, and most of the time I didn't feel like I was doing a very good job, but you know, I was the representative for the class, so if we messed up, ultimately it was on me, so I tried my best to you know, build everybody up and try to support everybody as best as possible. And I'm really excited, and I'm proud of each one of my classmates to see them grow from, you know, 32 weeks ago till now, and I'm really excited to see what they're going to do. 82nd, where are you at? One of my favorite academy moments happened in the first few weeks. I have two dogs, and I really struggled with having their dog hair on my uniforms, no matter how much I tried. And training officer Redder asked me one morning formation if I had a dog, which I told him yes. And then he asked me if I dressed him up in my fatigues over the weekend and took cute pictures with him. And I responded no, but that was one of the most memorable moments of my academy.
Well, it looked like you did.
First, I have to thank my wife. There's a lot of nights that I came home pretty miserable or discouraged, and you know, you're always there for me. I also appreciate you ironing for me. Also, I want to thank my brother, sister-in-law. You're a tremendous support for me, and I was very thankful that you're down here. And I have to thank my mom. I wouldn't be here without you. Thank you to the rest of my classmates. I was the class leader, and you know, I tried to be as positive as possible and as uplifting, but on days that I struggled, you really picked me up. So thank you to all of our class members and to the training staff. It was a interesting journey with the relationship going from training officer to mentor. And even though there's a lot of days that I wouldn't say I was angry with you, but maybe just didn't like you at the beginning, I knew that there's a rhyme and a reason for everything. And as we progressed to the academy, turned into a mentorship, and you know, myself and I know the class are eternally grateful.
Benjamin Moffitt.
Hi, I'm Benjamin Moffitt from Powhatan, Virginia. I'm 20 years old. Before this, I was a police service aide, or PSA, for Chesterfield County. I'm looking to either get into supervision way in the future, or I want to do SVU, Special Victims Unit, and help the vulnerable. Who inspires me are my family members that have served in the military, my brothers currently in the Navy, and my uncle and my grandfather, both are Navy veterans. I want to thank my family, my mom, dad, sister, and brother who have helped me out through this, especially my mom and dad who have helped me throughout this entire process. I want to thank my my friends, my cousin, all my other family, my grandparents. I want to thank my church family for helping me out throughout this entire process and giving me encouragement through it all. And I also want to thank my classmates who have been with me alongside the whole time and have really been there throughout everything.
Caitlin Shepherd.
I'm Caitlin Shepherd. I'm from Chesterfield County, Virginia. I graduated from Clover Hill High School. I'm 24 years old. Before this, I was in the 79th Basic Academy, got injured halfway through, and now I'm in the 82nd Basic. My favorite Academy memory would probably have to be transition day when we went to the bunker. The class was getting corrective PT because of me because I had earrings in and didn't ask. So that was my favorite memory. And then they asked why we were out there, and Hogan said, "Shep's gonna ship." So that's my favorite memory. I think I really want to just see what the road has to offer first and learn what I can from other officers. But some future goals, I think maybe K-9 or traffic team. I think the best thing about Chesterfield County is the community. I was lucky enough to grow up here and be part of that community. I'd like to thank my friends and family, my best friend Shelby, my twin sister Hannah. I'd like to thank my classmates, Carter, Clark, Cook, Hogan, Grimwood, and Moffitt for helping me through this journey. Also, I'd like to thank the training staff, all the officers who took the time to help us during scenarios and practical week. I know they have friends and family to tend to, but they took the time out of their days to be there with us. And then also I'd like to thank the command staff.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will now proceed with the presentation and pinning of the badges of office. Colonel Katz will present each officer with their badge. Afterward, I will request the person or persons that each officer has chosen come forward to pin the badge on their uniform. This is their way of expressing their appreciation for the support that they received while achieving the honor of wearing the symbol of public trust. It also symbolizes their need for continued support from family, friends, and co-workers as they enter the law enforcement profession. Please do not come forward until requested to do so.
Attention! Forward, mark. Back, face.
Sean Carter. William Clark. Cody Cook. Jordan Grimwood. Patrick Hogan. Benjamin Moffitt. Caitlin Shepherd.
The person pinning the badge of these officers, please come forward.
At this time, I would like to ask the Honorable Ms. Wendy Hughes to please come forward for the ceremony of swearing in of members of our graduating class.
Sean Carter, William Clark,
Cody Cook,
Jordan Grimwood,
Patrick Hogan,
Benjamin Moffitt,
Caitlin Shepard.
Do solemnly swear or affirm that I will support the Constitution of the United States, the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia, and the ordinances of the County of Chesterfield, that I will faithfully and impartially discharge and perform all the duties incumbent upon me as a police officer for the Chesterfield County Police Department, according to the best of my ability. So help me God.
Please stand for the benediction. Chaplain Lee McConnell, please come forward to deliver the benediction.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day and for these graduates, these officers. We pray that you will be their guide on this day and the days to come. Give them strength, determination, and perseverance as they pursue the noble and high calling that you have given them to enforce our laws. We thank you that they have chosen this profession, as it is not an easy one, but a much needed one in our society. We pray that daily you will give them faith, give them strength, and give them the determination needed to maintain their integrity and honor as they live out their noble profession. We pray that you will give them the wisdom needed in every situation they encounter, that they will be unyielding when necessary and compassionate at the right times. Please keep them safe along with their fellow officers as they serve our community as messengers of peace and righteousness. And Father, we thank you for their lives. We pray that you will bless Sean Carter, William Clark III, Cody Cook, Jordan Grimwood, Patrick Hogan, Benjamin Moffitt, and Caitlin Shepherd on this day and every day to follow. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Members of the audience, you may be seated. In just a moment, I'm going to call for the final dismissal of the 82nd Basic Police Academy. To the members of the 82nd Basic Police Academy, the training staff, the department, and the community congratulate you. Each of you have demonstrated a commitment to excellence throughout your training, and you have earned the title of police officer. We trust that you will continue to demonstrate that commitment as you serve the community of Chesterfield while preserving life and protecting the vulnerable. Training Officer Redder, please dismiss the class.
Keep my private life unsullied as an example to all.
Ladies and gentlemen, this does conclude our graduation. I would like to thank each of you for attending the special ceremony. Please feel free to approach the stage for photos with your police officer and drive safely.